Hello and welcome, and I'm showing you a really astonishing game that I had today, especially in my York. If you see that, I'm on my alt account, so don't wonder that I or ask if I changed the clan or something, my nickname. It's just my alt account. Yeah, incredible what happened there. It's absolutely an amazing game. I don't consider the York as like overpowered or such a fun ship, but in this game I had definitely fun because there were some prowling situations and some close quarters in Cyclone, and yeah, my team almost throwing it away, and yeah, kind of tensionful, and yeah, I liked it pretty much. All right, so we are on yeah, but by the way, what do you need for such games? Well, you need like mediocre teammates, you need mediocre and a bit worse enemies. You need the perfect map and the perfect matchmaking and a ship that can is capable of carrying at least a bit. Yeah, so it doesn't get overmatched by everything or something like that. And as we see here, maybe not too many battleships in one place, for example. So that's basically it. Yeah, and exactly that requirements were given here in this. I mean, you can't know it before, but somehow it turned out to be a really, really wonderful game. And I really wanted to share it with you. That's why I'm showing it, especially because there are almost no good games in New York on any YouTube channels, I think. Or maybe on... It was... Or yeah, replays wayos.com .com. So that's maybe the only source where I can assume that there might be some good replays. But yeah, nevertheless, enjoy this replay. I will talk a bit towards why I did what, and yeah, enjoy the fun because it's definitely gonna be some. All right, so. Two brothers, I decided to go to the left side. York is considered to be an HE spammer, so a German HE spammer. Since the Germans have this incredible 200 inbuilt IFHE, so to say, yeah, this ship is pretty strong. Because it has 210, so the HE pen is incredibly good. I think it doesn't differ that much, but if you hit cruisers or so, the alpha is a bit higher, for example. So, can be quite nasty, and the fire chance is also pretty good. As you saw, two volleys on the Bismarck and already two fires, and there we go, a follow-up fire, that means that's sticking, then there are going some torps from the Z-23. I'm just... Since I don't know how many ships are up there, I'm playing a bit cautious and stay angled away. But as you see, I'm like speeding up, slowing down, like the usual stuff that you do for kiting purposes. I'm not going too far away, so he has now a flooding. I'm pretty sure about the flooding and two fires for myself, so that's gonna be ticking and this guy should be dead then. Alright, so if I watch the minimap, a lot of stuff is going on at the D side, so yeah, why not playing aggressive here on yeah, the A cap. I am accompanied by Fuso and a Richelieu, so that should be undoable, even though when I lead the charge, but you know, they are battleship, they probably shit their pants when they see a DD up there and they won't progress. Alright. Our DD is alive. He's going into the A cap soon, I guess, to block it, and we can just play aggressive. But then suddenly another battleship appears, which is the Bayern. He was like sleeping the first 5 minutes, I guess. Otherwise, it's not explainable why he ended up now there where he is, but okay. I'm not so scared of that Bayern. The Bayern can be scary if he wouldn't have started shooting at that point on me as an angled target. So now I know, yep, I don't care about him too much. I'm going for the Gede and help my Z-23 to finish him off. Yeah, using my AA just to get some extra XP, or my Z-23 is concealed if needed, but yeah. Since there is no carry around, what would you do else, right? So I'm maintaining some angling towards the Bayern. I mean, he can overmatch me, that's nothing to joke about normally, but the penetration on the Bayern guns isn't that great, so it isn't too likely that he does that. I mean, I have to be really close that he's going to do that with me. I can finish off the Gede, who was somehow stuck in there. And now I can just push further ahead. Bayern has the guns somewhere else pointed at, I think at the Z-23. Yep. But fine with me. Another ship to farm. Yeah, as I said, it's an incredible game. They are not shooting me, then they damage come the first fire when they see the torpedoes pass them, so yeah. Typical expert battleship play. In this regard, I'm happy that it's happening on the other side, so on the enemy team and not on my side. Yeah, there's one consecutive fire. I'm, of course, checking out that I'm staying angled, but he's shooting whoever. I think probably the Z-23, who's also constantly shooting, so... Yeah, I think for him, I'm right now the bigger threat, but I think he realizes a bit too late, in my opinion. Aim not totally on point. I think I have to take a bigger lead here. Okay, two fires ticking, so I'm aiming for the bow to get a third fire ticking. And lucky me, that's three fires, and this poor guy is burning like nothing. He's turning, I'm turning in, slowing down to whiff his shots, which work perfectly fine. So I have 70k damage and didn't take one hit. So if every game would start like this, then I would say you played perfectly in your cruiser, or you were just lucky. It depends. Alright, so also the announcement, Cyclone incoming. So what do you want to do in a Cyclone? Of course, you want to bunch up. Best case is you stay close to a battleship. Battleship is the one who tanks for you, and then you can like attack with or in the vicinity of the battleship. Means the enemy who's going to charge in or whatever doing has to face like a battleship accompanied with cruisers, maybe even a destroyer, and that can be really nasty. But in the Cyclone, you want to stick as close as possible. You want to guard yourself altogether, so that's basically what you should do, my opinion. So here I'm a bit undecided if I should go south or should stick, but as I said, I thought about it going south, but then I can't use my range and I have to go in a close brawl and against like whatever battleships, so I don't want to do this in a York, even though it can be a good brawler, but the armor is debatable, I would say. It has turtleback, but it's not very strong turtleback, so don't expect to bounce a lot. So I'm already switching to AP just in case there's something coming close. Broadside on. The AP on the York, on the other hand, is pretty garbage because it has a slower travel time than, for example, the HE shell. So it's really only usable for the close quarters. Algerie is stopping there. But yes, yeah, motor boost on, so it's able to reverse quickly enough. So as you see, I'm staying with the Richelieu, and I hope he's maintaining his position, kind of, more or less. The Chapayev is down there. Since I just saw two DDs path, I assume they talked the Richelieu, at least I would have done that. So, yeah, I'm changing a bit of the course and use this island cover here to not fight everyone at once, in case of. Yeah, Xianyang is up. Switch to HE because I saw a lot of destroyers. Now there is Algerie. Yeah, there's the first top. Lucky for me that he has HE loaded. I'm just putting some torps into his, well, like throwing some torps in the general direction, but he stopped, so he was very aware of what is going to happen there. Means also that shouldn't be a big thing. At that point, I needed to open the door, so don't wonder if I don't do too much. Okay, now I should be back. Yeah. Alright, so that Algerie is coming closer. Which is surprisingly, I'm staying, of course, angled, maintaining the angles, because first of all, my two front guns aren't turned around yet, and Algerie doesn't show too much broadside. So it, the best case scenario for you is, of course, if you fight like one cruiser at once, but this Algerie is fighting us too. And now he's starting to give a bit too much broadside. That's what I can punish a lot. Otago just runs away. Yeah, but still, he's way too short, way too much broadside. Okay, that's triple citadel. I like it. Getting up a plane. Turret traverse is not fast enough for the Xianyang. So yeah. Alright, so far it doesn't look too good, actually. We are behind in caps, we are behind in points significantly, so yeah. Richelieu kills at least the Mayhem, which is good. But I think our Galazinier overextended there a bit too much. Yep. So there was a Huanghe, the mayship, ship, and an Otago. So obviously not what you wanna fight if you do so. Richelieu eats torps like candy, which is an issue. That should be Otago torps. As I said, I'm staying with my battleship, so I try to stay close enough to the Richelieu, but I couldn't. Huanghe is up because he couldn't wait anymore, and that's a real paper ship, as we all know. Okay, so torps into Otago's direction, waiting what he's doing, but he's doing nothing, so I'm waiting for this Huanghe to pop up and use my guns on him. So my plan is here to approach towards the Otago. I think these guns, these shells shouldn't hit. No. And go full ham. So this Otago, I don't know what he's doing. Or he seems to be a sitting duck. I guess he was worried about the Richelieu, I'm not sure. So I'm throwing one top launcher in this general direction, and of course use my speed and the superior top angles to approach the Otago even more, and then luckily the Huanghe appears, and yeah, that's game over for this guy. Way too much broadside. Otago ate a huge hit, so did I. He waited for the right time, shooting the superstructure. Meanwhile, gained high caliber and Kraken and Confederate, so pretty good, and gathered some damage. But still, things can go wrong. The enemy has still two battleships. Yeah, I'm a bit happy, so nom nom. I don't know what the plan of that Otago was, but I didn't like that play at all. Way too passive. He could have been way more aggressive and not sit there and be like, oh, pussy, pussy, pussy. But he did that, so. And he has also a heal, so I don't get why he did sit there, like. Yeah, don't know. Alright, so. Since I assume the decap is empty, I can just go and cap it. Yeah. Chatting in the chat that I'm, or writing in the chat that I'm a bit surprised how good this ship can perform under the given circumstances. Yeah, the Salrin guy is probably right. So yeah, what we saw was a full HP Amagi on the other side, or I think I can remember there was a full HP Amagi. Yep, there we see it. Cyclone is, yeah, it's over now, the Cyclone time, and I'm just calling that Aoba just run and survive, but I think it's too late for that, and I can just hope they don't, both of them don't die. I'm fine with the Fuso being up here. Our Fuso is at full HP. Enemy Fuso also. So literally the only thing he needs to do to yeah. To win this game for us, or more or less win this game for us, is just trade 1-for-1. Means just ram him and have fun. I know it's not a favorable ram, but he was anyways always sitting behind and not very useful, that Fuso player. So I'm asking him, Fuso, can you ram enemy Fuso? Because I assume it's gonna be really, really close. The Amagi killed the Aoba meanwhile, so yeah. I just hope our Fuso does know what he's going. I'm going straight for C, since the Fuso just left C, and I can cap it in case we need this. Yeah, don't think so. That's already not promising, what I've heard so far. I guess the Siren guy is watching him. Yeah. You can read the chat, so yeah. I was like, oh no, boys, please don't throw this. Please don't throw this. I'm also a bit concerned about the Z23, because he's utterly close to the Amagi, and yeah, in my opinion, not necessary. I mean, I think he's resetting from time to time, but it should be fine. If I cap C, they won't go in time into D, and the Fuso can somehow stay alive as long as possible. But the issue is, as you already see this guy writing in the chat, the Amagi seems to have angles on our Fuso, which is like worst case scenario. Because then he has to face two battleships at once, which he's throwing one at least broadside. And now I'm writing it in German, because it's his name appears German, so I'm writing in German, but he's not listening, sadly. And he makes the game more exciting. Not for me, that because I wanted to win this game, because it was like amazing and I wanted to share it the moment I saw how it's going to turn out for me with you, my viewers on the channel. And yeah. But it seems as if we are losing this fight somehow, yeah. Which is a problem. Yep, he just said there. Let the Fuso pass and show broadside to both of them, and he shot HE, what I heard. And the Siren guy is also not really happy, but luckily I have the shell arcs to shoot over here and reset that Fuso in case it's needed. Of course, only if I hit. Also have the Amagi. My line of sight, so if he turns back, so I'm aware of that and just can run away. Alright, so now I seem to hit. That Z23 made it quite smart. I think he launched one torp, set of torps, and then the other one, so the damage con is on. And Fuso eats torps and one of them on the nose, and he is flooding, so he's dead. So if I get a fire, he's 100% dead, and that should be the game for us. Yeah, no fires for me though, but two more resets, I'm fine. 30 seconds to go and we are still not leading, and now I realize, oh no, what is that Z23 doing? And because if he's dying now, there is no way back for us to win this. But it seems as if we can get or chunk down the Fuso right on time, and I'm already moving towards the channel because the Amagi turned around and he's probably hungry for me, and I just need to go and run. But he won't make it in 5 seconds, so we secured that win. That win, yeah. All right, so yeah, pretty impressive game. I had the luck of getting a super container on my alt account with 30 days of premium. So this is now with premium. That's why I'm playing it a bit more excessively. And yeah, this is probably the highest damage game I ever had in the York. And yeah, as I already mentioned, I wanted to share it with you because it was action loaded, tension full, at least in the end. Will we do it? Will we not? Will my teammates fail or not? Yeah, I guess all of you know it. As you see, a pretty decent fire starter with 12 fires. I was really lucky, and a lot of consecutive fires after damage cons. Of course, the prowling situation there with the Atago, the Algerie, and the Huang He was, I think, quite well played. The Algerie was won by a time, and then Atago and Huang He made both critical errors and didn't play their ships to the maximum. And yeah, let me go out as the succeeder. Yeah, and then also a whopping amount of base XP. I mean, 3.26k base XP. I mean, I was mid-tier, I think. Yeah, mid-tier. So quite unusual, but yeah. As you see, also doable. And then the result screen. Yeah, a lot of fire. It's like 1/3 HE shell damage, 1/3 AP shell damage. Ah, not almost. Yeah, well, because we have 2 torpids as well. Yeah, but almost like 1/3, because fires is also a point. Yeah, and I only showed once too much broadside towards that Atago. That's why where I ate the most damage. Both of the battleships didn't care for myself or didn't do anything to me. Also, I had luck that I didn't directly face battleships except for that Bayern who was running, and I had a lot of backup, and the Bismarck who was not able to survive very long. So yeah, that's basically it, and I hope you enjoyed this replay. Clan battles, I guess, from... Excuse me. Sorry, since I stopped smoking some weeks ago, my nose is cleaning sometime from time, so there come these surprise snoozes. I think it's snooze. I don't know. Apologies for that. Yeah, as I said, clan battles next week probably we are going to play again. Right now we don't have the players to play, and we will do it next week, I think, and for the last week, and hopefully I can upload some enjoyable games, and yeah, you will see then. All right, enjoy your weekend, and see you next time. Bye-bye.